Father, we thank you, we give you all the praise, we give you all the glory, we magnify your name, Abba Father. Thank you, Father, for this wonderful day that you have made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you, Lord, for another opportunity, Lord, that have given us, O God, to be in your presence. Lord, we are very grateful. Receive our thanks and praises in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we ask that you have your way, Holy Spirit. Have your way, Abba Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Manifest your power, O God, this night in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we plead the blood of Jesus, O God, upon the sanctuary. We plead the blood of Jesus upon our lives. We plead the blood of Jesus upon the atmosphere this evening in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says, O Lord, that you overcame the enemy by the blood of the Lamb, by the words of the testimony. Father, we declare and decree that this night, Lord, you overcome the enemy by the blood of the Lamb in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we plead the blood of Jesus, the blood that speaks better things than the blood of Abel. Father, Lord, we ask that blood rest upon us, O God. Let the blood of Jesus rest upon us, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the speaking blood of Jesus speak for us tonight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Eleka zuka lantarada boshukatagara. Eleka zakatarada balaka zakatagara. O Rabba Laka Zakantarada Balika Zakatagara. O Rabba Laka Zakantarada Balaka Zakatagudugara. He Kantarada Bushitarada Balaka Zakatagudugara. O Rabba Laka Ziladibushantarada Balaka Zakatagara. O Rabba Laka Zakantarada Balika Zakantarada Bushitarada. He Lika Zikalantarada Bazukantarada Bushukatagara. Eleka Zakantarada Balaka Zakatagudugara. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit, you're welcome in this place tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, come and have your way. Holy Spirit, come and take center stage tonight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit, come and have your way tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, come and manifest your power tonight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Eleka zukalantarada buzukutukara. O Rabba laka zakantarada balika zakata. Eleka zukantarada bushutarala gutukara. Eleka zukantarada balaka zakata gutukara. O Rabba laka zakantarada balaka zakata gutukara. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Bible says that they receive power when the Holy Ghost rests upon them. Tonight we receive power in the mighty name of Jesus. Through the power of the Holy Ghost, in the mighty name of Jesus, we receive the supernatural power tonight in the name of Jesus. Aluka zakantarada. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, declare that the ministers tonight are empowered with the power of the Holy Spirit. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Eleka Zukalantarada Balaka Zagadagara, Hurra Balaka Zakantarada Balaka Zagadagara, Eleka Zakantarada Balaka Zagadagara, Hurra Balaka Zakantarada Balaka Zagadagara, He Shentered Bulika Zakatarada Balaka Zagadagara, Hurra Balaka Zakantarada Balaka. Holy Ghost, have your way tonight. Holy Ghost, have your way tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, manifest your power. In the mighty name of Jesus, Haraka Lika Zakantarada Balaka Zakatugara, Hurra Balaka Zakantarada Balaka Zakatugara, Hurra Balaka Zakantarada Balaka Zakatugara, Eleka Zakantarada Balaka Zakatugara. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Father Lord, we ask you to tear the heavens open, O God, over tonight's service in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we declare the heavens are open, O God, tonight. Our Lord, as we listen to your word, as we sit at your feet, O God, to hear your word, Father, we declare and decree, O God, the heavens are open, O God, to receive from you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The heavens are open, O God, for your servant, O God, to download, O God, my Father, your word to us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We declare the heavens are open, O God, my Father, and let the angels, O God, descend and ascend. Send over from this sanctuary in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Halaka zukantarada balaka zakata gudugudugara. Hurra balaka zakantarada balaka zakata gudugudugara. Hurra balaka zakantarada balaka zakata gudugudugara. Halaka zakantarada balaka zakata gudugudugara. Hurra balaka zakantarada balaka zakata gudugudugara. Hishantarada balika zakantarada balaka zakudugara. Hishantarada buzukutarada balaka zakata gudugara. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father Lord, we ask you, God, as you sit in your presence tonight, Father, let there be transfiguration. Father, let our change, let our lives be changed in your presence. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let our minds, O God, be renewed, O God, in your presence. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, tonight, let every mountain in our lives melt like wax, O God, in your presence. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, let every situation in our lives, O God, bow before your presence. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, let your hand rest upon every one of us, O God, tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, as we sit, Lord, in your presence to hear your word, Father, let your hand, Lord, rest upon each and every person tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, your hand of power, Father, let it rest upon every one of us tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, your hand, O God, to bring transformation, Father, let it rest upon us, O God, tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, your hand, O God, to bring deliverance, Father, let it rest upon us, O God, tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, your hand that bring, O God, my Father, restoration, Father, let it, O God, rest upon us. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, your hand, O God, that fights for us, Father, let it rest upon us. In the mighty name of Jesus, O Rabba Laka Zuka Lantara Rabosutu, Raga Laka Zuko Terela Balaka Zagadagadagadagadagadagadag, O Rabba Laka Zakantara Balaka Zagadagadagadag, In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we pray that let there be an encounter, O God, my Father, with your power. In the mighty name of Jesus, let everyone, O God, my Father, who hear your word tonight, have an encounter with your power, have an encounter with your word. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Elikazuka Lantara Rabos. Father, we give you the praise, we give you the glory. Have your will tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, have your will tonight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, as your word comes, as the word of God comes forth tonight, Father, Lord, let there be power. Let the power be available tonight. Let the power to deliver be available. Let the power to live to be available. Let the power to save be available tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, let the power to redeem be available tonight. Let the power to restore be available. Let the power to transform lives be available tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, let your power fall tonight. Let every one of us, O God, encounter your power. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Uraba Shantara Balagazagara, Heleka Zakantara Rabo Shetagara, I Kantara Balaka Zagatagara, Uraba La Santara Rabo Sukutugara, Uraba Laka Zakatagara, I Kantara Balaka Zakatagara, Heleka Zakatagara, Uraba Laka Zakantara Balaka Zakatagara, Uraba Laka Zakatagara. Father, we give you the praise. Father, we give you the glory. Have your way, Lord, tonight in the name of Jesus. Manifest your power tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for the open heavens, O Lord. We thank you, Lord, for your power that is available tonight to change lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, Lord, my Father, for your spirit, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, have your way. Take center stage tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Manifest your power tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we give you all the praise. Father, we give you all the glory. Blessed be your name forever. Thank you, blessed Savior. In Jesus' name we pray. I'll give thanks. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Father, in the name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, we lift your name on night this evening. We thank you for bringing us into your presence, mighty everlasting Father. As we begin to lift your name on high through songs of praise and worship, Father, we ask that you have your way in our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. We give you all the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not, thy compassion they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Hallelujah. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand has provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Pardon for sin and the peace that endureth. Thine own deep presence to cheer and to guide. Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings are mine with 10,000 beside. Hallelujah. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand has provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Hallelujah. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand has provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. One more time. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand has provided. Great is thy
Jehovah, 247, I will praise you, Papa, 247, 247, I will praise you, Jehovah, 247, I will praise you, Papa, this kind of God, this kind God, never seen your type, oh, this kind God, oh, blessed be your holy name, this kind of God, oh, this kind God, oh, I have never seen your type, oh, this kind God, oh, blessed be your holy name, 247, 247, Jehovah, 247, I will praise you, Papa, 247, 247, I will praise you, Jehovah, 247, I will praise you, Papa, hallelujah, for the Lord our God, the Almighty reigns. For the Lord God, the Almighty reigns. Sing hallelujah, hallelujah. For the Lord God, the Almighty reigns. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. For the Lord God, the Almighty reigns. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. For the Lord God, the Almighty reigns. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. For the Lord sifa. Amen, amen. Wewe ndiwe Bwana, uinuliwe, wewe ndiwe Bwana. Amen, amen. Wewe ndiwe Bwana. Hallelujah, wewe ndiwe Bwana. Receive our praise, O Lord. Receive our praise, receive our praise, O Lord. Receive our praise, receive our praise, O Lord. Blessings and honor we give unto you.
Receive our praise, O Lord.
Alpha, Alpha, Omega, you are worthy of our praises today. Alpha, Omega, you are worthy of our praises today. Alpha, Alpha, Omega, you are worthy of our praises today. Alpha, Omega, you are worthy of our praises today. Alpha, Alpha, Omega, you are worthy of our praises today. Alpha, Omega, you are worthy of our praises today. Receive our praise, receive our praise, O Lord. Receive our praise, receive our praise, O Lord. Blessings and honor we give unto you. Receive our praise, O Lord. Receive our praise, receive our praise, O Lord. Receive our praise, receive our praise, O Lord. Blessings and honor we give unto you. Receive our praise, O Lord. Receive our praise, receive our praise, O Lord. Receive our praise, receive our praise, O Lord. Blessings and honor we give unto you. Receive our praise, O Lord. Tuna kuabudu Bwana, tuna kuabudu, tokuabudu, tuna kuabudu Bwana, tuna kuabudu, tokuabudu, tuna kuabudu Bwana, tuna kuabudu, tukisema wastahili ewe Bwana, wastahili ewe Bwana, wastahili ewe Bwana, kupokea, kupokea utukufu, wastahili, wastahili ewe Bwana, wastahili ewe Bwana,
wastahili, wastahili, wastahili ewe Bwana, wastahili,
wastahili ewe
Bwana. We worship you, Lord.
Wastahili ewe
Bwana,
kupokea
utukufu. We worship you, Lord. We adore you. Thank you for bringing us to this service today. Speak to us. Let no one leave the way he or she came. As we study the word of God, we ask God that he open our inner eyes, our eyes of understanding, so we can see mysteries in your word and adapt to it immediately. In the name of Jesus Christ, we ask, oh God, that this word will not stand against us on the last day. Rather, it will add value to us now and in eternity. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. You may be seated everywhere, except those who are doing essential services on the camera and all that. But I want to welcome all those who have joined us from different parts of the world tonight. We want to welcome you on the social media. God bless you in Jesus' name. Sylvia Chilwana, God bless you. Thank you for joining us. We see you join us online from Ethiopia. Dorcas Chepiatich, University of Nairobi, Upper Kabete Campus. God bless you. Thank you for joining us and the team there. Meshach Tiba, thank you for joining us. That should be from US. God bless you. Rita Ugumba from Nigeria. God bless you. Thank you for joining us. Kingsley Osahimen Ehato. That is from Scotland. God bless you. Thank you for joining us. As team, something like that. Abraham, I don't know where you joined us from. God bless you. But we appreciate you. Thank you for joining us. Angie from Scotland. Thank you for joining us. Please share the video and let others get connected, because in the next few minutes, we'll run through and then we'll pray, get the Holy Communion, and then we'll close. Get your communion elements available, ready, put it beside you, so that when I bless from the altar here, you take the communion right in your house, and it will serve the purpose that it is meant to serve in the name of Jesus Christ. All right. Pastor Adedayo Ojo, thank you for joining us from Nigeria. God bless you mightily, sir, in Jesus' name. All right. Let's go. Father, speak to us now. Glorify your name. Show yourself mighty. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I'll be teaching on the topic, the force of taking a stand. The force of taking a stand. The force of taking a stand. 2 Kings chapter number 18, verse 20 to 21. The force of taking a stand. Everyone needs to get a note to write, because I will download, including you. Get your notes quickly. I want to see it after the service. Everyone needs to get a note to write, because I will download. And I will want everyone who is hearing me to adopt that lifestyle, because that is the key to fast progress. That is the key to making it in life in an uncommon way. Many times people think standing in between here and there is nice. It's never nice. 1 Kings 18 verse 20 to 21. Can I see that scripture projected on screen, because I need it. The Bible says, so Ahab sent unto all the children of Israel and gathered the prophets together unto Mount Carmel. Verse number 21. And Elijah came unto all the people and said, how long halt ye between two opinions? If the Lord be God, follow him. If Baal, then follow him. And the people answered him not a word. I need other versions of the Bible so we can understand it. Be attentive there. I need other version of the Bible. NIV says, look now, you are depending. 2 Kings 18, verse 21. No. I don't want this. This is not the right scripture. This. What happened? There's no Egypt here. Sorry, 1 Kings 18. First, I was wondering what brought Egypt to it. 1 Kings 18, verse 21. All right. And Elijah came unto all the people and said, how long halt you between two opinions? If the Lord be God, follow him. If Baal, then follow him. And the people answered him not a word. Then give me other versions of the Bible so I can run. Elijah came near to all the people and said, how long will you go on balancing between two opinions? If the Lord is God, then give worship to him. But if Baal, give worship to him. And the people said not a word in answer. Another version quickly. And Elijah came near to all the people and said, how long will you be limping between two different opinions? If the Lord is God, follow him. But if Baal, then follow him. And the people did not answer him a word. Another version quickly. Good news is Elijah went up to the people and said, how much longer will it take you to make up your minds? If the Lord is God, worship him. But if Baal is God, worship him. But the people didn't answer a word. Now I read those versions for you to understand, you know, that verse. The Bible says, Elijah said, why are you standing between two opinions? I will tear that place in the next few minutes. See, when you stand hard, you will become a standard. I repeat, in life, when you stand hard, you will become a standard. But when you keep shifting grounds, you will never be a standard. Standards are people who stand hard. When you stand very hard, you become a standard. People start copying you, they start emulating you, they start behaving like you, they start praying to be like you. But when you are neither here nor there, nobody prays to be like that. The Bible says, when Jacob wanted to bless Reuben, he said, you are unstable as water. You will never excel. Genesis chapter 49. Can I have verse number 2? Genesis chapter number 49. Verse number 2. Can I have verse number 2? The Bible says in Genesis, project it, sir. Gather yourselves together and hear, ye sons of Jacob, and hearken unto Israel your father. Verse number 3. The Bible says, Reuben, thou art my firstborn, my might, the beginning of my strength, the excellency of dignity, the excellency of power. Look at all the good things that is accrued to this guy. Verse number 4 says something very dangerous. It will not happen to you. The Bible says, unstable as water, thou shalt not excel. Unstable, when you are always shifting up and down, you will never excel. People who do not have a standard in life never excels. Unstable as water, always changing. Today the price is low, another day the price is high. Today the price is this. You are always very greedy, always looking for how to add to it. You will never excel. Unstable as water never excels. When you make up your mind, you stand firm with it. When you stand firm with it, you become a standard. Again, when you cannot stand for anything, you do not worth living for anything. When you cannot stand for anything, you don't worth living for anything. You are a waste. Again, anyone who cannot stand for you at critical time is an unfaithful person at all times. Anyone who cannot stand for you at critical times can never stand for you at any time. You better don't depend on him. It is only those who can stand for you at critical times that can stand for you at any other time. Again, what you stand for determines what stands for you in life. What you stand for determines what stands for you in the day of adversity, in the day of problem. It is what you stand for that determines what stands for you in life. So what do you stand for? It is that same thing that will stand for you the day of adversity. Hallelujah. Everybody will always have a day of adversity, a day when you will answer for yourself. It is what you have been standing for that will stand for you. It is who you have been standing for that will stand for you that day. Again, I discovered again, when you stand firm, you become an anchor that God can manifest through. When you stand firm, you become an anchor that God can manifest through. But when you are always shaking, God cannot manifest through you. Because you're unstable as water. Anything unstable does not excel. Excellence is removed from anything unstable. Again, in life, only those who make a choice will have a choice. Only those who make a choice will have a choice in life. When you have not made a choice, you always, well, I will confirm later. I will call you, I will see what happens. You will never be a choice to anybody. Nobody will ever choose you. Even you will never have a choice. You will always be kicked up and down, played up and down. Whenever people see you, they play you here, they play, because you've never made a choice. It is only those who make a choice that always have a choice. Never make yourself an unstable person on earth. Again, I discovered again that when stand for what you can die for, and what you can die for will stand for you. You didn't hear me, I repeat. Stand for what you can die for, and that thing that you can die for will stand for you. In the day when all things go down, that thing will stand up for you. Again, I say, when you deny or betray people to save your life, you will end up losing your life at crucial points on earth. You always betray people. You deny them. I was around, but I didn't really know what happened. I don't really know. In fact, I was just around. Or you just pretend. You walk away. One day, at the crucial point of your life, nobody will stand for you. You will die. You will go. We will tear you away because you have never stood for anybody. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. Again, I discovered something in life. A slippery person is not a smart person, but a dubious person and a fool. A slippery person is not smart. No, many times when people are very slippery, they say, I'm very smart. Nobody can catch me. You are a fool. Very soon it will catch up with you. One day there will be people will dupe you, and people say that is the way he is. He does it like this. So we don't even know what is happening to him. Please take him away. We don't know whether I say the truth or telling a lie. Nobody will help you because you have been slippery all the days of your life. Again, I discovered that a person of dual personality is a chameleon, can never be depended upon. Dual personality, you don't know whether he's with you or against you. He's smiling with you. He's also smiling with an agent of the devil. He's also around. See, one of the signs to know when somebody is slippery or when somebody does not have an opinion, the right opinion about you, is when the person is relating with you and also a very close friend to your enemy. Very close. But they will come and laugh with you and pretend everything is fine. And you see him also eating and playing with you. The person that told you are a fool to your face, he is dining with the person. Oh, and that happens a lot in Nairobi. You see the same. The person will boldly go to you, the person attacking you, and also come back to you. I'm coming. I want to tear this place well so you can understand how to behave. All right? Then again, a person who loves to please both parties is a hypocrite. He loves to please this person and please this person. He's a hypocrite. In life, you can never please everybody. The Bible says it's either you love one or you hate the other. You cannot love God and mammon. It can never happen. You either choose one. You cannot be serving God and serving. It's a lie. You either choose one. That's what the Bible says. You must choose one. You must choose one. So do not stand in between two opinions. The Bible says to us, Elijah asked these people, why are you standing between two opinions? Why? What is the reason? You have stood between two opinions. Rain stopped falling. You stood between two opinions. Famine came. You stood between two. You are neither here nor there. People are suffering and you are not bringing solution to their problem. You are hiding, pretending that you are not the cause of the problem by standing between two opinions. Again, let's get to the scripture so I can show you the Bible, because all that I said is right in the Bible. Mark chapter 8. Mark chapter number 8, verse 35 to 37. Mark chapter number 8, verse 36 says, for whosoever will save his life shall lose it. But whosoever shall lose his life for my sake and the gospel's, the same shall save it. Look at the scripture. There are people who are in between two opinions to save their head. I don't want trouble, though. It's not that I don't know what happened, but I will not say anything. Whatever, let God save him and you go away. You will lose your life very soon. You will lose it. I don't want to get myself in that problem. Why don't you take a stand? I am not getting to this problem, but this is what I know. This one is this, and this one is that, and the problem is solved. But when you refuse to speak, the problem escalates, grow, and the quagmire increases, and then everybody is in trouble, everybody is confused, and you are claiming you don't want to be in trouble. You will soon be the chairman of trouble. That's what makes people waste. You see them wasting away. You see them crying and nobody helping them. Why? Because the seed they planted. The Bible says, he who saves his life shall lose it. But whoever loses his life for God's sake and for the gospel's sake shall save it. The Bible says, or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? Proverbs chapter 25, verse 19. Proverbs chapter number 25, verse 19. We are studying the Bible today. Proverbs chapter 25, verse 19. The Bible says, confidence in an unfaithful man in time of trouble is like a broken tooth and a foot out of joint. Confidence in an unfaithful man. Unfaithful man is somebody in between two opinions. He's here and he's also there. He's there and he's here. He's not anywhere. He's not supporting anybody. He's a middleman. Middlemen are very dubious people. Everywhere you see them. Very dubious. They have their selfish interest to cover up. He says, confidence in an unfaithful man in time of trouble is like a broken tooth. I don't know whether your tooth has broken before. The pain it gives you and your mouth will swell up like this. People will think you have HIV when they see you. And it will be smelling. It's like a broken tooth or a foot out of joint. Imagine when this place dislocates and you are walking like that. And people would think you have committed an offense. Maybe you stole somewhere. That's why they broke your leg. This morning I was standing there and I saw the plumber. Is it not the plumber? Walking like this. I said, what has he done? Has he gone to steal and they broke his leg overnight? So I asked him, plumber. And I know he's the one. What happened to him? See, when your feet dislocate, it is very painful. The Bible says when you trust an unfaithful man in time of trouble, it's like that feet that is removed. So don't be an unfaithful person. May God not also allow any unfaithful person to connect with you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So you be faithful Alright, let me show you people that were unstable. People that could not take it in life. They were neither here nor there. They were supporting everybody. Let us check them. Number one, the first person I want to show you today is Jonathan. Jonathan. Somebody called Jonathan. Jonathan is the son of Saul. The first son of Saul that was supposed to become king after his father. Jonathan. Jonathan loved David and also loved his father. At some point, Jonathan needed to make a decision whether to stick with David or to stick with his father because his father hated David. Jonathan stuck with his father for some time, but he knew that God's hand was on David. In fact, he loved David. The Bible says he loved David like a woman loves a man. That's what the Bible says. Jonathan loved David terribly, but Jonathan was caught in between two opinions. He was neither here nor there. The Bible says he fired his father and said, "What had David done that you want to kill David?" And his father threw javelin at him. He dodged it and he went and reported to David, "My father wants to kill you. Don't worry, I will make sure he doesn't kill you." He was running between the two opinions. One day, the Bible told us concerning Jonathan in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 23, verse 16 to 18. 1 Samuel chapter 23, verse 16 to 18. And Jonathan, Saul's son, arose, went to David into the wood, and strengthened his hand in God. And he said unto him, "Fear not, for the hand of Saul my father shall not find thee. And thou shalt be king over Israel, and I shall be next unto thee. And that also Saul my father knoweth." Verse 18. And they two made a covenant before the Lord. And David abode in the wood. Jonathan went to his house. Do you know Jonathan never returned again? Why? Because he went back to his father. The Bible says in 2 Samuel chapter 1, verse 2 to 4. And it came to pass in the third day that, behold, a man came out of the camp with his clothes rent and the earth upon his head. So it was when he came to David that he fell on the earth and did obeisance. And David said unto him, "From whence comest thou?" And said unto him, "Out of the camp of Israel have I escaped." And David said unto him, "How was the matter? I pray thee tell me." And he answered that the people fled from the battle, and many of the people also are fallen dead. And Saul and Jonathan his son are dead also. Why? Why did Jonathan die in battle with his father? Because he could not take a stand. He was for his father, he was for David, and then he followed his father and died. When you don't take a stand, you will soon perish. You will waste. You will never have anything to your name. Do you know he already told David, "I will be second in command to you. I am supposed to be king, but I relinquish the kingship because I can see the hand of God upon you. So I'll be second in command to you." He was second in command to his father. He was second in command to David. He was second in command to his father. He wasted his life. Stand somewhere. How I wish the day he went to David and told David, "I'll be second in command," and the two of them made the covenant, he never returned to his father. He would not have died. He would have been second in command to him. But he lost his life. Why? Because he was caught between two opinions. He was second in command to his father, second in command to David. The hand of God was on David. The hand of the devil was on Saul. He perished with this other one. Stand. Take a stand in life. Some of you see me behave like that. When I step in, I say, "This is the way." You talk, I say, "I have spoken." And I follow it. You see it work through for me. Up until now, everybody, all of you who ever encountered me, you see me display what I'm teaching you. When anybody talks, I keep quiet. When they finish, I say, "This is the way we are going. If you don't believe it, use the gate." And I stand my ground. You see, working for me. Not only here, everywhere I go to, every matter of my life, that's the way I stand. Including my marriage, including my children, I stand my ground. This is the way it goes. Oh, no compromise. Because as you keep compromising, your destiny will be compromised. You will soon waste away, sir. That was all wasted Jonathan away. Jonathan was a very good man. Jonathan was a very nice guy. He was not a liar. He had love in his heart. He was a very nice guy to be with, but he could not take a stand. That was all wasted Jonathan away. He never became vice president. He was neither here nor there. He was for Saul, he was for David, and he wasted his life. Again, let's go. Gehazi is another one. Gehazi was a man who was following Elisha. Elisha got double portion of the anointing on Elijah, and Gehazi was supposed to get quadruple portion of that same anointing because he was following, he was the one serving Elisha. He was a very good guy, serving very well, very diligent. But at some point, when he could not make up his mind to stick with Elisha, the anointing started leaking. The Bible says at some point, they gave him a rod loaded with power to go and lay on a child that had died. When he took the rod there, the rod became empty. Why? Because he was standing between two opinions. He loved money. He wanted the reward now. He loved money too much than the anointing. So he wasted away, sir. The Bible says at some point, certain rich man came to consult his master. His name was Naaman the leper. He brought leprosy to his spiritual father. His spiritual father told the leper, go and take your bath, and then when you take your bath, you'll be clean. For the long story was a bit long. Finally, the man took his bath and became clean from leprosy. And the man came for Thanksgiving and brought bag of money. And the master said, I'm not collecting the money. You can go back to your master. The Bible said, Gehazi said, see money. Nibo, I will follow after this guy. He loved his master. He loved the anointing. He also loved money. So he said, okay, fine. Let me run after money now, and then I run back to the anointing. He ran after money. The Bible says he went in the book of 2 Kings chapter 5, verse 20 to 27. The Bible says he ran after Naaman the leper. 2 Kings 5, 20 to 27. It's a long reading, but I'll tell you what is there. He ran after Naaman, collected the offering, ran back, hid it somewhere, ran to collect the anointing. And the man of God said, where were you? He said, I've been around. The man of God said, didn't my soul went after you when you ran after the man and the man turned back? Is it time for you to start collecting money? Since you are caught between two opinions, you don't know when to follow the anointing and when to follow money. The leprosy of Naaman will now be your portion. The Bible said he collected it immediately. He left his presence as white as snow. Why? He was caught between two opinions. Two. If you read verse number 26, but he says, and he said unto him, went not my heart with thee when the man turned again from his chariot to meet thee? Is it time to receive money and to receive garment and olive yard and vineyard and sheep and oxen and men servant and maid servant? The leprosy therefore of Naaman shall cleave unto thee and to your seed forever. And he went out of his presence a leper as white as snow. That is what happens to those who are in between two opinions. You are running after God, you are also running after money. Make up your mind what you want. Make up your mind what you want. He left his presence. A man that was supposed to collect anointing times four. Gehazi was supposed to be a dangerous man, sir. In fact, he was supposed to be more dangerous than Elisha. Elijah did 16 miracles that we could count in the Bible. Elisha did 32 miracles. He did the 32nd miracle when he died. The Bible says his bone raised up a dead man that they dropped on his burial ground. The dead man jumped up. That was the 32nd miracle. This guy was supposed to do 64 miracles. This guy, or more, because he would collect four anointing times four. Can you imagine? He collected leprosy because he was in between two opinions. He ran after Naaman. I said, let me also run after the anointing. He lost both. He lost the anointing and lost the money. What will he use the money to do when he had leprosy? Normally, lepers will be kept in lepers' colony. So what will he use the money to build? To buy a car? Useless money. He lost both. The amount he didn't collect, money didn't favor him. He lost it. Why? Caught between two opinions. Number three, the third person that I studied my Bible and found that is caught between two opinions is called Judas Iscariot. Judas Iscariot was caught between two opinions. He never decided and made up his mind on what he wanted. The Bible says to us in Matthew chapter 26, verse 7 to 16, the Bible says somebody gave Jesus an offering. Judas Iscariot got angry. He got so angry that it became an indignation. He shouted at Jesus and said, this alabaster box of oil that was broken and poured on you should have been sold and given to the poor. Jesus said, quiet! The poor you have with you always, but me you don't have always. This is done for my burial. The Bible says he did not do that because he loved the poor. It was because he was a thief and he had the bag. As soon as Jesus rebuked him, he got angry. That's how many people behave. When you tell them the truth, they swell up and they walk away. I've seen many of such. They swell up and walk away. The Bible says Judas went away from the presence of Christ and went to the high priest. And went and said, Daddy, you're my spiritual father. Daddy, do I used to follow Jesus? So don't mind that Jesus. You're my spiritual father. In fact, I can hand him over to you. The Bible says he went to the chief priests and betrayed Jesus and told them that he could hand Jesus over to them, and they bargained. They were negotiating on the head of Jesus, and they bargained and settled for 30 shekels of silver, and they promised him they were going to give it to him. And he began to look for opportunity to sell Jesus, and he finally succeeded in selling Jesus. How did he end? The Bible says he committed suicide. The money he collected on the head of Jesus, he took it back to the temple before he committed suicide. He said, I've betrayed an innocent soul. They said, say, hey, forget that. We'll sort yourself out with that. That's what they told him. The Bible says he took the money and he cast it on the altar there. The Bible said they packed the money and they bought a field. When he went out, he went and committed suicide. The Bible says in the book of Acts of the Apostle, Peter stood up, said Judas Iscariot was supposed to be part of the disciples, part of the apostles, but he lost it because of greed. He said, therefore, let somebody else replace him. And immediately they cast lot and somebody replaced him. That is what happens to those who are in Jesus' church and in Chief Priest's church. They are in every church. Caught between two opinions and the place. They are everywhere. They are member. Many member. They are member here. They are member there. They are everywhere. They are, everybody is their father. Judas, his spiritual father, was both Jesus and the high priest. Look at the way he wasted away. In fact, he sold Jesus. He died before Jesus. He hung before Jesus hung on the cross. He already hung himself. He never lived to enjoy what he gained. What did he get? 30 shekels of silver. He never lived to enjoy it. I traveled to Israel some years ago, and I told them I've got SIM card of Israel, and I put it in my phone. And I told them, can I get airtime? So I told them I want 10 shekels, because I remember Jesus was sold for 30 shekels. And then their money is called shekel. So I said, I want 10 shekels. They said, there is nothing like that. They said, I should buy like 100 shekels or 200 shekels. I said, why? Ah, Jesus was sold for 30 shekels. Who Jesus? My friend gave me 2 shekels, sir, for 1 shekel. They began to laugh at me. Because I was wondering, how come Judas Iscariot sold Jesus for 30 shekels that cannot buy airtime in our generation? Why? Greed. How I wish he sold him for an amount that will buy the whole world forever. He sold the whole Jesus for 30 shekels. That's what caught between two opinions does. At the end, he never lived one day to enjoy the one shekel out of the 30. He wasted away. Make up your mind and take a stand in life. When you stand hard, you become a standard. When you stand hard, you become a standard. When you stand hard, you become a very great standard in life. Let's go. Let me show you another person. Another person that wasted his destiny, Ahithophel. I read my Bible and discovered a man called Ahithophel. Ahithophel, the Bible says to us, he was a counselor to the king. He was counselor to King David. The Bible says, whenever he counseled, his counsel was like an oracle counseling. My God, 2 Samuel chapter 16, verse 23. Ahithophel was a great man of God. He was loaded with wisdom. Whenever he sat with king, kings tremble because the guy is like he hears from God directly. The Bible says in 2 Samuel 16, 23, and the counsel of Ahithophel, which he counseled in those days, was as if a man had inquired at the oracle of God. That guy was a great counselor. When he counsels you, he's on the point. Whatever he says, like a prophet speaking. The Bible says, so was his counsel of Ahithophel, both with David and Absalom. His counsels were super. His counsel was full of wisdom. But the Bible says, one day, he refused to take a stand. He was standing with David. After a while, he went to stand with Absalom. Absalom is David's son that rebelled against David. So he went to stand with the rebellious, and he committed suicide a few hours later. The Bible says in 2 Samuel 15, verse number 12, and Absalom sent for Ahithophel the Gilonite, David's counselor, from his city, even from Gilo, when he offered sacrifices, and the conspiracy was strong. He conspired against David. Whenever you relate with the enemy of somebody, you are a conspirator. I repeat it one more time. Whenever you connect yourself with the enemy of another person, you are a conspirator. You know that this person hates this guy, not because the guy did anything evil. You know he did everything right, but this guy does not like what he's doing. And you are neither here. You are part of the group. You always go to continue. Don't worry, he's apostle. Apostle Eric, very tough guy. Don't mind him. You are their friend. Then you see me say, you're a man of God. You know we respect you. You're a great apostle. You are a conspirator, sir. I saw it in my Bible. That was what he did. The Bible says when he joined that group, the conspiracy became very strong. The Bible says to us, one day, David prayed a prayer. When David heard that he was part of those against him, the Bible says David prayed and told God that his counsel should become foolishness. Verse number 31, 2 Samuel 15, verse number 31. And that's what I pray for every conspirator around my destiny and around your destiny. Anyone conspiring against you, may their counsel become a foolish counsel in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says, and one person told David, saying, Ahithophel is among the conspirators with Absalom. And David said, oh Lord, I pray thee, turn the counsel of Ahithophel into foolishness. And God answered that prayer. Don't be caught in between two opinions. If you are standing with with someone, say, I'm standing with you. Even if the person is wrong, say, hey, you are wrong. You did this, like this, like this, and like that. Now, this is the way, but I am standing with you. Let's go. Don't do that again. That's the way to relate people. Not, you did it wrong. He take off. I caught him. He did it wrong, though. We can deal with him now. Look at what he did. He's an idiot now. So you have to, please hide it. Don't say I'm the one who tell you. He's just between two of us. So, yeah. And then you talk about saying, you know, Muse, you're a good Muse. Yeah, Muse. In fact, you're a Muse. Yes, Muse. And you're healing him. When the trouble comes, bam, they don't see you anymore. Bam, you vanish. And you're the one who created the trouble. Then you'll not be watching from afar off. You'll not be peeping from afar off. Why? Because of your wrong spirit inside you. I command that kind of wrong spirit to die in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Spirit of Ahithophel, I set it on fire. I decree to never prosper. Ahithophel committed suicide, sir. Let me show you the Bible. Ahithophel committed suicide. I saw it in my Bible. The Bible says in 2 Samuel 17 verse 23. 2 Samuel 17 verse 23. The Bible says, and when Ahithophel saw that his counsel was not followed, he saddled his ass and arose and got him home to his house, to his city, and put his house in order and hanged himself and died and was buried in the sepulchre of his fathers. And he refused to stand his ground. Are you with David or with Absalom? Who are you with? You think you are smart? You are with David, you are still with Absalom. You will soon commit suicide. It's a matter of time. Especially, thank God I know my Bible. God has used these prayers to deliver me. You see, they laugh with they're also laughing with the devil. May God turn your counsel to foolishness in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Everyone should work on their character to know where you are standing. Take a stand in life. Take a stand. Take a stand. Take it. When you take a stand, God supports you. But when we don't know where you are standing, who do we support? How will God support you? I saw somebody again in the Bible who never had a stand. See, if you are with your parents, a child, you are a child, you are with your parents, stand with your parents. If you're not with, let us know you are rebellious so we can beat the hell out of you. Hallelujah, praise God. Yes. This is Africa here, sir. So we know who you are. Don't pretend here and there, and one day we see you paraded as one of the armed robbers that they just arrested. Why? Because you are neither here nor there. Another person I saw in my Bible that never took a stand in life and never became a standard and went down into the grave. His name is King Saul. King Saul, the father of Jonathan. King Saul. The Bible says when he became king, Samuel told him what to do and he never did it. The Bible says in 1 Samuel chapter 15 verse 22 to 31, and Samuel said, he was talking to him, verse 22 now, 1 Samuel chapter 15 verse 22, had the Lord has great delight in burnt offering and sacrifice, and in obeying the voice of the Lord, behold, to obey is better than sacrifice, and to hearken than the fat of rams. For rebellion is at the sin of witchcraft, and stubbornness is equal to idolatry. The Bible says, because thou hast rejected the word of the Lord, he has also rejected thee from being king. When you don't obey God, you are neither here nor there. God will reject you. I'm seeing it in my Bible. I'm showing it to you. That's why you see a lot of people who got favored at some point, rejected because they are caught between two opinions. They are not standing on any spot. They don't have a standard. They are everywhere. The Bible says again in verse number 24, and Saul said to Samuel, I have sinned, for I have transgressed the commandment of the Lord, and I was, but I feared the people and obeyed their voice. Have you seen? He was with God and also with the people. He wanted to make the people happy and also make God happy. He neither made anybody happy. He wasted his destiny. He said, I fear the people. I wanted the people to have something to eat. I also wanted to sacrifice to the Lord thy God. He was neither here nor there. He lost both. He lost both. The Bible says in verse 26, and Samuel said unto Saul, I will not return. Okay, in verse 25, now therefore I pray thee, pardon my sin and turn again with me that I may worship the Lord. Have you seen? He wants to worship God. He also wants to respect the people. The Bible says to us in verse 25, and Samuel said unto Saul, I will not return with you, for thou hast rejected the word of the Lord, and the Lord had rejected it from being king over Israel. And as Samuel turned about to go away, he laid hold upon the skirt of his mantle, and it rent, it tore. The Bible says in verse 28, and Samuel said, the Lord has rent the kingdom of Israel from thee this day, and hath given it to your neighbor, the neighbor of thine that is better than thou. The man of God wanted to go. He grabbed him. Maybe because he was taller than Samuel. He grabbed him and said, I will hold you here. You must do what I ask you. So the man of God tried to go. He pulled his clothes and the clothes tore. And the man of God tore. I was now covering his boxer shorts. I said, yeah, you tore my clothes. I prophesied. God, in the kingdom of God, the kingdom away from you, you will never be king again. He forced him to do sacrifice. The man of God held his skirt like that and was doing sacrifice under pressure. But the Bible says, from that day, God rejected Saul. Where are you? Servicing the people and servicing God. I've made up my mind. I was talking to someone, I don't know who I was talking to, and I said, I've made up my mind. I better lose you than lose God. And I meant what I said. I was in another realm. I prefer losing you. I don't care who you are. Than losing God. I prefer making God happy and you disappear from my life. I'm very fine with it. I make up my mind. Look at Saul. He was pleasing people and pleasing God. He never pleased any. God rejected him. When God rejects you, people will run away from you. You are like a skitter. Have you ever seen somebody after downloading a skitter, he's now dancing? I say, child, see this fantastic skitter. Whoa, it looks good, man. If I smells well, is anybody like that? Have you not noticed that when people download a skitter, they run away from it? Oh, you don't know. When people download, they run. They can even spray perfume and they walk away. They don't stay in the perfume and say, the perfume smells well. He will smell feel. Why is he spraying? To cover the smell of the download. Excuse me, sir. When God rejects you, you are a download. You are a poo-poo. Even if they spray perfume on you, people will still run away from you. When God rejects you, everything I've rejected you, you are finished. Oh, glory to God. May God not reject you. Therefore, always stand. Take a stand in life. Don't ever be in between opinion. Stand somewhere and say, this is my stand. I'm not changing. Excuse me. I've made up my mind here. When you take a stand, everything around will begin to stand for you. Hallelujah. Let's go a little bit more. Number six. The sixth person that I saw that did not take a stand is a man called Demas. If you read the Bible very well, Demas was a good servant of Saul. He served God in the days of Saul. He was a good guy. He was serving God. One day, we understood what happened to Demas. We now saw Demas in another realm. The Bible says in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 10 and 11. One day, what is inside you will come out. Every deceiver will be exposed. No matter how you hide, it will be exposed. Every deceiver will be exposed. It doesn't take time, sir. I have seen it happen. Before I came here, while I'm still here, I'm seeing it happen. If you're a deceiver, it's a matter of time. You should be exposed by the power of God. The Bible says in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 10 to 11, for Demas has forsaken me, having loved this present world, and is departed into Thessalonica. Demas has forsaken me. Demas used to follow Paul up and down. I am your protocol. I love you. I am part of the head of the department. I am this and that one because the anointing was flowing. Nobody knew that Demas also loved the world. He wanted to be, you know, wear trousers that falls off from the buttocks region. You know, I wanted to fry his hair as a man. You know, he wanted to palm it and put on one earring in one ear and then wear one shoe that had been rejected from Japan so he can be bouncing like this. You know, how those boys. So you think he had just arrived and then carry one long phone, one iPad, and he calls it phone so that he can make phone call. People can now respect him and say he has arrived. The Bible says, Demas has forsaken me, having loved this present world. Demas was supposed to be a great disciple. He lost everything by forsaking the house of God. Why? He was caught between two opinions. He loved the thing and he also loved God. He loved it. After a while, the thing took over his love for God. Stand, take your stand. Where are you standing, sir? You know, one day Jesus came to his disciples and said, who do men say I am? Somebody said, excuse me, sir. They said you are a prophet. Another said, excuse me, sir. And they said you are Elijah. Another one stood and said, sir, they said you are John the Baptist. When they all finished, he said, who do you say I am? You know, many times when people talk to me, the person says this, the person is that. When you finish, I say, what have you said? Because what you say that matters. It is what you say that makes us know who you are, whether you are for me or against me, by what you say inside. What have you said? Some of you have had me ask you that question. When you talk, in Kenya, this is what we do. In Nairobi, it happens. Like, when you finish all the story, I will ask you, what have you yourself said? Because I want you to take a stand. Stop running. You know, when you get to a barber's workshop, when you sit, the barber's workshop, they talk like this. They tell me, talk like this again. Stop turning like the chair of a barber. Get a good seat and sit straight so we know who you are. Hallelujah, praise God. Do you know, David took a stand. He took a stand and his destiny opened up. May God help you to take a stand in life. God wants you to take a stand. May God give you grace to. That's why I'm teaching this. Everybody watching me online, those hearing me live, God wants you to take a stand so you can become a standard. Take a stand. Stop running up and down. Stop being in everywhere. Be in one place. Be focused. Make up your mind. Stand hard so it can be a standard. Stop lying. It is grayish, bluish. It is yellowish. Tell us the truth. Is it black or white? Say it straight the way it is. Stop forging it. You will never go far. Unstable as we never excel. Excellence will be taken away from you. That's what the Bible says. All right. David took a stand. 1 Samuel 17 verse 32. He took a stand and he became a standard. Till today, people are still respecting David in Israel. Nobody respects Saul because he never took a stand. When you take a stand, you become a standard. When I went to Israel, I saw everything was named after David. King David, King David, King David, King. Everything was named after him. Why? He took a stand. Let me show you where he took a stand. 1 Samuel 17 verse 32. 1 Samuel 17, the Bible says, and David said to Saul, let no man's heart fail because of him, because of Goliath. Thy servant will go and fight this Philistine. That was the day he won. I will go. I take a stand. I will deal with Goliath. When you take a stand, immediately the game changes. Everybody were running. The Bible says he had seven or eight brothers. Seven brothers. They were part of the army of Saul. Nobody could take a stand to fight Goliath. All of them were saying, and we'll see how it goes. And we'll confirm. I'll confirm. And Takupigi, I'll call you. I'll call you. Takupigi. Just a minute. I'm coming. All of them. Even Saul left and went home and went to hide. And now made a law. Whoever can kill Goliath, I will make him very rich. Whoever can kill him, pretending. Whoever can kill Goliath, I will make his father's house free in Israel. Whoever can kill Goliath, I will do this and I will do that. When he finished announcing, they said, hey, sir, why don't you come? He said, no, I'm very busy. I have some administrative issues to handle. You know, Goliath is too small for me to handle. He was hiding. He couldn't take a stand. The Bible says, when David came and said, I will fight, he said, wear my jacket, wear my armor. Why didn't he wear that armor and face Goliath? If you trusted that armor, why couldn't you wear it? Now, he couldn't wear it because he couldn't take a stand. David took a stand and God made him a standard. He said, fine, I cannot wear your armor. It's not my size. You are taller than me and I don't need your armor. Since your armor cannot help you, then I don't need it. It cannot help me. And he went and took the stones that he knew how to use and God supported him. When you take a stand, God will support you. God will stand with you. The Bible says he came out from one corner and then Goliath looked at him and said, who are you? Look at this boy. In fact, I cursed you by my God. He did not know that he had crossed his bound. And David told him, you come to me with swords and stay, but I come to you in the name of the Lord of hosts whom you have defied. Today, he will give me your head and I will carry this your big body and feed the birds of the air. The man thought he was joking. He ran towards him and David took out one stone and set it and God gave him victory. Goliath was flat on the floor. He won. Why? He took a stand. Take a stand so you can win. Take a stand. Who are you standing for? When they send you on errand, who are you standing for? The person who sent you or the person you are sent to. Many people go, when you send them on errand, go and buy this flower. They will go there and they will get there and say, I am sent to. It's not really me. Now even me, I need to make my own gain, you know. How much is it? Say, okay, it's 15,000. Now, let's say it is 20, so I can, at least I can get my own now, you know. I'm the one who brought the business to you, fine. So let us now tell him it is 20. Then you come and say, my sir, in fact, I bargained, I negotiated. In fact, the guy was even insulting me. And then you collect 20,000, you pay the guy. In fact, you collect the receipt, you say, sign, the guy sign. You go, you now say, hey, Muse, send my money, or else I will kill you. And you go, hey, you have not taken the time, you are an armed robber, sir. The day the trouble will start, the day Sakala will bust, thief, the day, so probably one day, they are praying every thief in this church, catch fire. You will catch fire, sir. Fire will consume you. That is the truth. It will hit you because you have stolen. The Bible says Ananias and Sapphira could not take a stand. They could not take a stand. The Bible says they took money to church. The pastor asked them, is this the whole amount for the land? They said, yes. Was that not a lie? Because instantly he fell down, passed and died. Young men picked him up and went to bury him. The wife came. The pastor asked again, are you sure that you people sold the land for such and such amount? She said, yes. The man of God said, hey, the people that went to bury your husband are on the way. They will soon pick you up to bury you. She fell down and also died. Why is God doing that in the church? To teach us that you need to take a stand for righteousness. Say the truth. Stop playing games. Don't be a thief. 1,000 shillings, 5,000 shillings, it will kill you, sir. It will. Take a stand. Take a stand. I made up my mind. Everybody knows my stand. Everyone who works here must be paid what we agreed. No, I won't delay your payment. As long as I have it, I will do for you and pay you. As long as I have it, I will locate you and make sure you are paid. There's nobody who works here that will not be paid. Not one. It's a standard. It's a standard here. You can be ready. Go and sleep. You'll get your money, Ujere. That one, we're not negotiating it. You don't need to beg for it. You don't even need to text and remind me. There's no need for it. There are people that did work here and they left because there was no money available there. By the time the money came, I'm the one who called them, located their phone number, called them, send it to them. I asked, say, what is their phone number? Tell them we're paying them. Wait, and we clear it. That's what I do because it's standard here, sir. Oh, no man. It's a law. You don't need to beg for your money. It's your money, sir. You work for it. You collect it cash by the grace of God. Why? It's a standard. I created it a standard. I don't want anything less because the Bible says when you collect people's wages, you are a wicked person. God will punish you for it. You have their money in your pocket. You are using it to get more money. You are a very wicked fellow. Hallelujah. All right. Let me show you a few things and then I close. Job chapter number 8, verse 12 to 15. If you refuse to stand hard, if you are always not taking a stand, let me show you who you are. You are a hypocrite. The Bible says in Job 8, verse 12 to 15, you are not smart, you are a fool, a hypocrite. You refuse to take a stand. Always, when trouble comes, you quickly shift. You don't want to be part of it. You don't know who to stand with. When trouble comes, let's assume you're a member of this church now. Trouble comes, and people say, we are coming to arrest pastor. You say, hey, I used to be a member, but not a full member. You are a hypocrite, sir. One day, your day will come. You are planting a seed. You will reap it. Heaven and earth will deny you and you will be gone. Yes, you win. I have many stories to tell you, but I won't tell you. So I don't scare you. If you are standing, stand. If you are not standing, leave. The Bible says in Job 8, 12 to 15, whilst it is yet in his greatness and not cut short, it withered before any other herb. So are the path of all that forget God, and the hypocrite's hope shall perish. Whose hope shall be cut off, and whose trust shall be a spider's web. He shall lean upon his house, but he shall not stand. He shall hold it fast, but he shall not endure. Why? He's a hypocrite. You will lean like this, the thing will fall. Whatever you're leaning on, will go down, because nobody can lean on you. You are dubious. Nobody can lean on you. Nobody can rely on you. You're unreliable. Again, in Job chapter 15, verse 34, the Bible says, for the congregation of the hypocrites shall be desolate, and fire shall consume the tabernacle of bribery. That's how you see when people are asking for bribe. You see me telling them, you are a thief. You want to collect money, Abi? You want to collect bribe? Mr. Too, you've had me do that severally. You are a thief, eh? You and your thief, I will be hitting you straight with it because your tabernacle will never last. It's in the Bible here. The Bible says, fire will consume the tabernacle of bribery, sir. You want to collect bribe? Collect a cost money. I'll be telling you straight how what you are looking for. Many of them say, no, they won't. Some of them say, give me. Because they want to perish. It's in the Bible. See, for the congregation of hypocrites shall be desolate. You are neither here nor there. In between. You are everybody's friend. The Bible says the condition of the hypocrite shall be desolate. What does it mean to be desolate? To be empty. They will look for you. They will not find you. You will not be there. That's what the Bible says. So take a stand in life. Everywhere you enter. You are proposed to three girls. You love this one. You also love that one. You also love her. Yeah. I just love you. Love one. You're not taking a stand. You love everybody. You will soon be desolate. We'll look for you, can't find you. Desolate is when the house is supposed to be filled and there's nothing in the house. It's desolate. Again, Job chapter 20, verse 5. Job 20, verse 5. The Bible says that the triumphing of the wicked is short, and the joy of the hypocrite is for a moment. Hypocrite, you are neither here nor there, a deceiver. The Bible says your joy is for a moment. It will soon fade away. Your sorrow will resume duty for a long time. You are a fool. A foolish man. Imagine you are walking for sorrow. And then you are happy now. Yes. I'm very smart. They couldn't catch me. Then you are not very happy. The boss is for a moment. After a while, this joy will disappear. Sorrow will not resume. So don't be a fool. Don't be. Take a stand in life. Take a stand. Stop jumping up and take a stand. Who are you standing for? Where are you? Who are you for? When you see two opinions, make up your mind where you are. Don't be between two opinions. Stop it. Again, Job chapter 34, verse 30. Job 34, 30 says, that the hypocrite reign not, lest the people be ensnared. Hypocrites, they don't reign. Even when you prepare a throne for them to sit, they will never sit there. Because the Bible says, when the hypocrite reign, people will enter trap. Snare is trap. A hypocrite sitting on the throne is a trap. So God doesn't allow them to reign. The hypocrite reign not. They don't reign. You don't take a stand, you will never reign. You will forever be under, begging, looking for leftover for the rest of your life. You will never reign. You can never be a king. Even when the anointing to be a king is on you. Why? Because you're a hypocrite. Because you are never taking a stand. You are everywhere. Again, Proverbs chapter 11, verse number 9. Proverbs 11, verse 9. The Bible says, an hypocrite with his mouth destroyeth his neighbor, but through knowledge shall the just be delivered. A hypocrite with his mouth destroyeth his neighbor, but through knowledge shall the just be delivered. How many times have I encountered hypocrites around? And they tell lies on me and they say everything. And God delivers me through knowledge. In this nation and around the world. Sets me free, sir. Create things against me. I will just walk out by the grace of God. Hypocrites, they don't last. It's a matter of time, sir. It doesn't last. So when somebody's, I've just begun to say, it's a matter of time. This one will feed. Make up your mind to always take a stand. If you are for watching, just be for watching. If you are against us, stand and say, I'm against you. So we know who our enemies are. And not pretend you are for us and you're still for the devil. Stand. Take a stand, sir. Take a stand. Take a stand. Stop joking around. Take a stand. You are going to marry her. Stick with her. You are not marrying her. Tell her I'm not marrying you. Let's close that chapter. Let's not deceive each other here. You are there, be there. If you are not there, let us know you are not there. Hallelujah. Matthew chapter 6, verse 2 to 6 says, therefore, when thou doest thine alms, do not sound the trumpet before thee, as the hypocrites do in the synagogue and in the streets, that they may have glory of men. Verily I say unto you, they have their reward. But when thou doest thy alms, let not thy left hand know what thy right hand doeth, that thy alms may be in secret, and thy Father which seeth in secret himself shall reward thee openly. The same thing repeated in the same story is replicated in another form. Now listen, many times when hypocrites want to do something, they make noise. You know, we are working in world changers, so they show up, they're swelling everywhere, they're making noise. They take photograph with me, they photograph where they wrote world changers and put it on Facebook, on Twitter, on WhatsApp. So I say, child, that guy is one of us. Is he lying? Then he goes to his shrine. He joins them again. You must reach out for that. There's a photograph there too. So everybody's confused. That's always around when it is the loudest. See, if you cannot stick with people when they are dark, you are useless when they are shining. Yes, I repeat. You cannot stick with people when it is dark. You are very useless to them when they are shining. Hallelujah, praise God. So make up your mind not to be a hypocrite. Make up your mind to take a stand in life so you can become a standard. The Bible says in Luke 11:44, woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for ye are as graves which appear not, and the men that walk over them are not aware of them. You are a grave. Hypocrite. A hypocrite is a grave. The Bible says again in Mark chapter 7, verse 6. Mark 7, verse 6. The Bible says, he said and said unto them, Well, Isaiah prophesied of you hypocrites. It is written, these people honoreth me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. That is Judas spirit. Jesus, the holy Jesus. Baba Jesus, the holy Jesus. The lie. He's also healing the high priest. Holy high priest. Baba high priest. That's Judas Iscariot for you. So who are you? Who are you? Let me give you the scriptures I used at the beginning again. 2 Kings 18, verse number 21. 2 Kings 18, verse 21. Bible says, Elijah came unto all the people and said, how long halt ye between two opinions? For how long are you hanging between two opinions? Divided in the mind. You don't know where you are standing. Are you for what Jesus or against what Jesus? Are you for this man or against him? Where are you? Where are you standing? How long? Genesis 49 verse 3. It's one of the scriptures I use. Genesis 49 verse 3. Project it together as I close this service now. Genesis 49 verse 3. Make up your mind in life so you can be a standard. Make up your mind. Genesis 49 3. Reuben, thou art my firstborn, my might, the beginning of my strength, the excellency of dignity. See how this guy was overqualified. The excellency of might, the excellency of power. Everything about him is excellency, 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 excellency. Verse number 4. Finish the home of the stable at unstable shall not excel, because thou wentest up to thy father's bed, thou then defilest thou it, and when he went up to my couch. Unstable, you are neither here nor there. You are connected and hooked up. You are everywhere. Unstable as water. Excellence is taken out of you that you will never excel. And this curse affected this guy for the rest of his life because he was unstable as water. Don't be unstable in life. You will never get any good thing from it. It will make you like a grave, according to what Jesus said. People will be climbing you and passing, they won't even know you're a grave. Chai. Make up your mind. Anytime there's an issue anywhere, take a stand. Anytime there's a matter anywhere, take a stand. Don't be in between. Whenever I ask you a question and they're in between, oh my God, it irritates me. I say, look at this person. Anytime I say, where are you? I am. Then I say, look at the signboard, look around. Tell me what is written where you are. When you see hypocrites, look at the signboard. What's the name of the area where you are? Since you cannot say the truth, since it's difficult for you. I want you to pray, Father, help me to always take a stand in life. I refuse to hang between two opinions for the rest of my life. I make up my mind where to be part time. Anytime an issue is before me, I make up my mind, I'll stand in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Bow your head, talk to God. Help me, Lord, to take a stand in life so I can become a standard. Help me. Help me, Lord. I want to be a standard. I want to excel. I want to excel in life. I want to excel. I want to do well. I want to do well in life. Help me, oh God. I ask you, God, for your grace. I'm asking for grace, Jesus. Are you sure you are there? The person there, are you sure you are there? Don't let me ask you that again. Go ahead, talk to God. Lord, help me. I want to take a stand in life. Jesus, help us to take a stand in life. Oh God, help us. Help us to take a stand in life. Oh God, please, help us. Help us not to be neither here nor there, dubious. We are supporting those who are against the church. We are also supporting those who are for the church. We are neither here nor there. We are neither member nor non-member. Father, please help me to take a stand in life. All the days of my life, I want to take a stand. Help me, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I make up my mind today to be a standard. Go ahead, pray. Make me a standard that others can emulate, that others can follow. All the days of my life, I want to be a standard that others can emulate, that others can follow, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I will not be shifting or swinging up and down. I will not be running up and down, oh God. I will stick with you all the days of my life. Father, you can trust me. You can trust me, oh God. When people are caught in between two opinions, they cannot be trusted. Please, Lord, I've made up my mind to stick to a path so you can trust me, so you can bless me. Thank you, Father. We give you praise and adoration. Lord, I've taught your children your word. I have done my part. Please do your part in their life. Help each person that have had my word and those that will ever hear it to take a stand in life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Can we have the communion, please? Pastor Grace, can we have the communion now? Let's bless the communion for everybody. All those who set up their communion in the house, lift it up. Let me pray on it. Father, we thank you for this communion. We ask, oh God, that you put your breath upon it. Everyone taking the communion, I decree they shall be blessed. I declare the body and the blood of Christ in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Wherever you are, lift it up and then raise it up so I can bless it and then you take it. The Bible says, for I have received of the Lord that which was delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which you were betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take it. This is my body which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. After the same manner, he took the cup. When he had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as often as ye drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death till he come. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Wherever you are, go ahead. Take your communion right now. Take your communion right now. And the Lord God Almighty will bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. As soon as you take your communion, get out your offerings and give your offerings. After that, take out time to pray and tell God, help me to be a stable person. I refuse to be an unstable person. I refuse to be here or there. I refuse to always say something that is not so. I will take a stand. Whatever I say, people will meet it like that. If I need to change, I will come and say, I'm sorry. This is not pretend. Blend it. Roll it up. Pretend. No way. If I need to adjust, I'm sorry, I made a mistake here. This is how it ought to have been. I made a mistake. I want to be a straight person, oh God. I want you to depend on me, Lord Jesus. Lord, I ask, oh God, that you bless each person, giving their offerings right now. Let the offerings be accepted by you in the name of Jesus Christ. All right, project the pay bill, 821430, so that it can be used. Wherever you are in East Africa, you can use the pay bill, 821430, to give your offering. And God will bless you mightily in the name of Jesus Christ. So go ahead, give your offering. Do it deliberately. Don't be unstable. I'll give you later. I'll check. I'll confirm. There's no need to confirm. Give your offering straight. There's no need to play games about it. There's no need at all. There's no need. Hallelujah. Praise God. There's no need to play smart about it. If you're outside Africa and you want to give your offering, they will project the SendWave app. Use the SendWave app to give your offering. And God will bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. Don't play games. There's no need to play games about that. Pretend you are smart. Go ahead, give your offering. And the Lord will bless you. If you need the account of the church, it will be projected also. So you can have access to that account. Who is in the studio? I hope you're not so playing games. Project the send wave. And then after that, you project the account. Please, don't play games too. Do it straight. Very good. Do it very well, please. Don't do it haphazardly. Do it with joy, sir. Thank you. All right, Father, I release grace upon everyone giving and those who have given. Let your mighty hand rest upon every giver in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I decree as we begin to pray, as we close this service here and people begin to pray on their own, remember them. Remove everything that makes a man not to be stable from their lives in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let instability be over so that we can become somebody in life. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. We pray. Amen. At this point, we'll call it a day here today, and then we'll meet again on Thursday when it shall be prayer riot. I'll be leading us to pray on Thursday, seriously. So prepare yourself to pray on Thursday. We shall have a great time in God's presence. And then on Sunday. And then next week, we shall be having various programs which we shall announce to you. But please, for now, I want you to take out time to pray on your own, asking God to make you a stable person, not a dubious person, always shifting goalposts. Trying to get more gain, trying to get more money, trying to get more money that will not pay you. Judas got the money, but he died and the money didn't do him any good. So Gehazi got the money and leprosy finished him. The money couldn't cure the leprosy. So there's no need for those extra money. They are just stupid to get. So don't get them. There's no need for them. May God give you what is commensurate to be your blessing in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord bless you. I decree that this word will help you to add value to you. It will cause you to succeed. In the name of Jesus Christ, I decree that the hand of God rests mightily upon you, and God will cause you to be the fortunate one in the name of Jesus Christ. Receive grace to be stable so that you can be reliable, so God can depend on you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. God bless you. Bye-bye. Have a wonderful night. See you again.